Everything that you've been through all led up to this one moment. The rejection, the disappointments. But today, it's your turn not to go through the door, but to go through the roof. They blocked you. They hindered you. They stood in your way. They wouldn't allow you to come in. But guess what? It's your turn. It's your time. The door is too small for your God. Go through the roof.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. We want to welcome you to the worship on the roof here at Living Faith Tabernacle. We want to praise God. We want to worship Him. We want to lift His name on high. Y'all ready to do it?
Yeah.
Come on, let's go. Hallelujah. We serve the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. Come on. Bless your name, God.
You make the blind man see. You make the lame man walk again. You cause the dead to rise. And that's why we dance in liberty. Cause you're doing it all again. Come on, clap. See, yeah, yeah. Lord, you're doing it all again.
You keep making me wait.
you. We came for no other reason than to glorify and magnify your name. For truly you are God and God alone. We say thank you for another day. Thank you for another opportunity. We just came to give you glory. Somebody help us magnify his name.
Searching for what my eyes cannot see. Where to serve.
What a mighty God.
Yes, you're mighty.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God.
Hey guys, it's Pastor Tuck here, and thank you so much for checking us out on this morning with our Worship on the Roof service. Listen, we are going to be back in the sanctuary really, really soon, and I can't wait to see you guys. Let me start off by saying, listen, I thank all of you for giving and supporting the church. You know, we've been blessing the community, not just this community, but we've been able to bless Kenya and other people across the world and even in our own community. So I'm grateful for you, and I just want to say thank you to all of our supporters, to all of the people that have given. I appreciate you. Of course, there are several ways to give here in the Living Faith Church. You can text, you can do PayPal, you can write a check, you can come by the church. The office is open Monday through Thursday. But listen, we thank you, and I just want to say thank you for partnering with us and thank you for supporting us. Here in the Living Faith Church, we always say a decree, and tonight or this morning, I'm going to share that decree with you. And if you'll say it with me, this is my seed. God bless me with this seed, and today I'm planting this seed. Guess what? It will, it shall, and it must reap a harvest. In Jesus' name, amen. I love you, and I can't wait to see you.
I shall be, and I shall go with victory. No weapon formed against me will ever overtake me. I shall rise. And I shall be, and I shall go with victory. No weapon formed against me will ever overtake me. And because God, He is the greatest,
power,
we shall never be defeated.
And because God
is the greatest power,
then
we shall never be defeated. Oh, thank you for your love. Cry, oh, we'll never be defeated. Oh, no, no, no. Come on, let's do it together. Said, I shall go. Victory. Come on, declare it. Said, there's no weapon formed. Said, against me,
will ever overtake me.
Nah, let's say it together. And because God, come on, He's the greatest.
He's the greatest power.
We shall never be defeated. And
because God,
we are more than conquerors. Through the blood that cleanses us,
we shall never be defeated.
If you believe it, say it again. And because God
is
the greatest power,
then
we should never,
we shall never be defeated.
I don't care what it looks like, because God is the greatest power, then we should never,
we shall never be defeated.
He's a liar. God is exalted. Never be defeated. Never be defeated. The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God
is exalted.
You will never
be defeated.
Never.
Come on,
say it. The devil is a liar.
Liar.
My God, he is.
God is exalted.
above your situation.
God is exalted.
He's high above your sickness.
God is exalted.
My God is exalted.
God is exalted.
My God is exalted.
God
right here.
Said
the devil is a liar.
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 Encourage
our neighbor.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
There's nothing that he can't do.
God is exalted.
Say, God is exalted.
God is exalted.
If you believe it, let me see you give God praise. If you know you're more than a conqueror.
Good morning, living faith. Look, the devil is a liar and God is exalted. Listen, I'm still worshiping God. I hope you guys are this morning. Listen, I feel so good down in my soul. Do me a favor and share this with some people and tell them we are worshiping on the roof. Listen, share this with some people this morning. Y'all come on in and let some people know that living faith is worshiping on the roof this morning, and let the devil know that he's a liar, and let him know that we are going to win in this season. Do me a favor, lift your hands and bless God. If you know that we are winning in this season, that God is going to take us from one level to the next, come on, lift your hands and just begin to worship with me. If you know that the devil is a liar and that God is exalted and he can never be defeated, I don't care how hard your situation is, I don't care how hard your circumstance is, you are not defeated. That's right, lift your hands. You are not defeated. You are victorious and you will win. I don't care what's going on in the news. You are going to win. You are going to succeed. Why? Because this is your time and this is your moment. Come on, lift your hands. Come on, for 30 more seconds. Right there in your home, right there driving in your car, right there in the living room. Come on, lift your hands and begin to open your mouth and just begin to bless God, because God is the greatest power and he will never be defeated. God, we give you glory on this morning. We give you glory on this morning. Come on, will you magnify him with me? Come on, let's pray this morning. God, we thank you for your power and for your anointing. And we thank you, God, for the worship that has went up before you, God, on this morning. And God, we ask that you go and touch every person, that you go and touch every sister, every brother, every person that is discouraged, every person that wants to give up. We speak strength and power over them. And we speak that your anointing and that your grace will subdue them. And God, we thank you today for allowing us to do what we do, for allowing us to worship you freely, for allowing us to bless you on this morning. And God, we thank you because you are awesome and you are mighty. And God, we give you glory and we give you honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Listen, if you guys are just coming in, do me a favor and share this with some people and let them know that this is Living Faith and we are worshiping on the roof. That's right, we are worshiping on the roof. And I want you to know on this morning that God is about to take you from one level to the next. I know you've been at the bottom for a long time, but you are getting ready to go from one level to the next. God is getting ready to take you from one level to the next. As many of you know, I am a lover of the word and I love the word. And so on this morning, we're going to be coming from the book of Mark 2 in one. So if you do me a favor and just grab your iPads, grab your phone, and go to Mark 2 in one on this morning. The word of the Lord reads, a few days later, when Jesus again entered into Capernaum, the people heard that he had come home, and they had gathered in such large numbers, and there was no room left, not even outside the door. And he preached the word of God. Some came bringing to him a paralyzed man, and they were carried by four other individuals. Since they could not get him in the door, the Bible says that they carried him up to the roof, opening the roof above, digging holes and tearing the roof apart. They lowered the man down to Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said unto them, "Son, your sins are forgiven and you are healed from your disease." So listen, on this morning, I want you to write this down. When the devil blocks the door, go through the roof. I want you to write it down. When the devil blocks the door, go through the roof. So let's talk about this story on this morning, because we understand that there is a man who has been paralyzed. And when you understand about a person being paralyzed, you have to understand that he had palsy, which means he was paralyzed. And when you're paralyzed, that means you have a muscle disorder. So he had a muscle disorder, which caused him not to be able to walk. It caused him not to be able to function in a way that he could do the things that he needed to do. So let me say this to you on this morning. It is vital that you start doing a friend search and start looking around and making sure that the individuals that are around you can carry you in this season. There are some people that are not going to be able to carry the anointing and the greatness that is on your life. Come on, y'all, now listen to me this morning. There are some individuals, they can't carry you in this next place that you are going. Find you some people that can carry you in your weak time and in your weak moment. So this is the thing. What I appreciate about the four guys is that they did not let him quit. Because many times I have asked God, why won't you let me quit? I've tried to quit this thing that we call ministry, that we call church. I've tried to give up so many times. Why? Because people have jumped in the way. But I've asked God so many times, why won't you let me quit? Why won't you let me stop? When you see this man that is a paralytic, when you see this man that is paralyzed, the Bible says that he has friends that will not let him quit. They won't let him quit so much until they carried him to Jesus. Question, can your friends carry you? I gotta ask that again. Do you have friends that can carry you, or do you have friends that all they want you to do is carry them? But when you need to be carried, they are nowhere to be found. This man had friends that were willing to carry him. They says, listen, we can't let you quit. We can't let you stop. We can't let you throw in the towel. We are going to carry you even though you can't carry yourself. Do me a favor, ask yourself some questions and start going through your Facebook, your Twitter, your Snapchat, and start asking yourself, can I count on these individuals to carry me even when I cannot carry myself? Yeah, I'm gonna say it one more time, because I think you still sleep this morning. I want you to go through your Facebook, your Snapchat, your Twitter, come on, your Instagram. I want you to go down your friend list and ask yourself a question, can you carry me even when I cannot carry myself? Come on, y'all don't hear me in here, because we are carrying people that God never meant for us to carry. But can you carry me even when I cannot carry myself? God wants us to carry ourselves. God wants us to find individuals and people that are ready to carry us even when we cannot carry ourselves. Now let's keep walking through the story, because the story gets real good. They get to where Jesus is. I need you to catch this. They get to where Jesus is. They get to where Jesus is, and when they get to where Jesus is, the Bible says that no one allows them to come in. And let me tell you what people will do. People will see you broken. People will see you torn apart, but they won't let you in. They'll let you stand on the outside. Now, you would have thought common courtesy. Come on here. You know, and courtesy ain't so common now in the 21st century, but common courtesy would have said to me, this man is on a mat. They're carrying this man. They're carrying this individual. Why won't we just let this man in? But the Bible says that the house was so full until they says, listen, you cannot come in here. So listen, let me tell you what the friends did. The friends got together and they says, look, we are going to carry you because you are weak. You are weak in this moment, and we are going to carry you, and we are going to push you like we have never pushed you before. Bible says that they not only carried him all the way to Jesus, but they pulled him upside of the roof. See, can you carry me and pull me? Bible says that they carried him and pulled him upside of the roof. Now this is the thing that I got to take a little pause. You know, I got to really take a little pause, and I got to tell you this. Bible says they go on the roof. When they get on the roof, the Bible says that they begin to do something because they realize that they couldn't get in. So they begin to tear the roof apart. Listen, They didn't have any tools. The Bible don't record that they came with a hammer and that they came with nails. But the Bible says that they began to tear the roof apart. Can I submit something to you on this morning? That your worship is getting ready to take the roof off of your situation. Your worship is getting ready to transform some things that have never been transformed before. Come on, come on. Your worship is about to do what you've been trying to do for years. Can we take 10 seconds and just begin to worship God? Because our worship is about to get the attention of Jesus. Our worship is about to produce something that has never been produced before. Come on, go. Come on, 9 seconds, open your mouth and just begin to worship him. Come on, 8 seconds, open your mouth and just begin to bless God for what he's about to do for you. You came up the side, now you're at the top. Come on, 7 seconds, open your mouth and lift him up. Why? Because God is faithful to you. Come on, 6 seconds, come on, open your mouth. Come on, that's right, that's right, that's right, that's right. Some of y'all need this morning. Come on, some of y'all gotta have this morning. Come on, because you are about to go through the roof. Come on, 5 seconds, that's right. Uh-huh. Come on, come on, come on. That's it. Come on. Come on. That's right. You're getting ready to go to the roof. Your worship is about to do something that has never been done before. Your worship is about to produce something that the enemy has tried to block for years. Come on. 3 seconds. Come on. We are almost there. Come on. Just begin to worship him. Lift your hands. Open your mouth and begin to talk to God. Come on. 2. Come on. That's right. That's right. We worshiping on the roof this morning. That's why I'm so happy and excited, because look, when the devil blocks the door, go through. Come on, 2. That's it. That's it. We almost there. Come on, 1. Yeah, that's it. Come on, lift your hands, open your mouth, and say this with me. I am getting ready to emerge. Come on here. I need some people that are watching this morning that are saying, I'm getting ready to emerge from a low place, from where people looked over me, to now they're getting ready to look for me. Come on, say it with me. Come on, say it with me. The Bible says, come on, I'm about to run. Come on, and ain't nobody chasing me. Come on. Bible says that they begin to tear the roof apart. They begin to make a sound. They begin to create a sound. They begin to produce a sound. And I'm convinced that Jesus is looking for a sound. Let me say it one more time. Jesus is looking for a sound. He's looking for us to produce a sound that is going to get his attention. I believe that all of this stuff that we are going through right now in this pandemic is God is trying to get us to produce a sound that we have not produced before. God is trying to get us to do something that has never been done before. The Bible says that they produced a sound that got the attention of Jesus. Now, let me ask you this question on this morning. Can you produce a sound that's going to get his attention? Yeah, you know, we've been giving him dry worship. Come on. Because some of us, we become very commonplace. We become very comfortable in where God has us. But I'm asking you on this morning, can you give God a sound? Can you give a sound or make a sound that is going to get the attention of Jesus? Bible says that they begin to make a sound on the roof. Come on, hear somebody. They begin to make a sound on the roof. And when they begin to make a sound on the roof, the Bible says that everybody begin to pause and they begin to look, and the same people that looked over them and that could have let them in the door now has to look up to them. Let me help you on this morning, that your sound is about to do what everybody else has been paying for. Come on here. Your worship is about to put you in places that everybody else has been paying for and trying to get into those places. Bible says that their sound got Jesus' attention. And after they got Jesus' attention, the Bible says that the room is silent, and now they're letting the man down in the room. And as they're letting the man down in the room, he begins to emerge from the roof. Let me help you. Listen, some of you are trying to go through the door, but let me help you. The door is too small for your God. God wants you to go through the roof. Come on, say it with me. I'm going through the roof. Say it with me. I'm going through the roof. God didn't let you quit because you're getting ready to go through the roof. God didn't allow them to let you in that room because you're getting ready to go through the roof. I need three people, four people, five people that are watching on this morning that says, my business is getting ready to go through the roof. My ministry is getting ready to go through the roof. My everything is getting ready to go through the roof. The Bible says they go through the roof and the man emerges, and the same people that looked over him are now looking at him. Listen, you ain't got to worry about the individuals and the people that don't want to let you in the door. Why? Because you are anointed for the roof. Come on here. You are anointed to go to a place that they, listen, you, some of y'all trying to fight people to get in the door. You trying to rub elbows to get in. You trying to push other people. And let me tell you, God never called you to the door. God called you to the roof. I'm talking to some roof people on this morning that said, God called me to the roof. I need you to say, God called me to the roof. He called me to the roof. He called me to the roof. And you are getting ready to emerge. Come on here. I want you to say that with me. I'm getting ready to emerge. Come on, say it with me. I'm getting ready to emerge. I need all of my people that are getting ready to emerge. I know 2020 has been crazy. We all rolled in 2020 talking about 2020 vision. We all rolled in 2020 talking about we're going to see it better now, and this going to be the best year ever, and it's been the worst year ever. We've all been in quarantine. We've all been locked up. But why have we been locked up? We've been locked up because God wants us to produce a sound that has never been produced before. I don't know about you, but since I've been in lockup, come on here, since I've been in quarantine, guess what God has done? God has produced something in me that has never been produced before. Let me keep going, because I need you to catch this on this morning. You must understand and you must know, they let the man down from the roof and he began to emerge. Y'all go catch this. He began to emerge through the roof. There are some of you that are getting ready to emerge. People ain't gonna expect to see you coming. Why? Because they were looking for you to come through the door. They were looking for you to come through the door. They had no idea that you were getting ready to come through the roof. Come on. They had no idea that you were getting ready to come through the roof. They had no idea that you were getting ready to do the things that you were getting ready to do. They were looking for you to come through the door because they had the door blocked. But what they didn't know was is that you had a worship on your lip that's about to take you from one level to the next. That you had a worship in your hands that's about to take you from one level to the next. And so on this morning, for my worshipers and for my people that says, I'm getting ready to emerge. And just because you have the door blocked doesn't mean that God is not going to allow me to come through this roof. You are getting ready to come through the roof. Come on. I need some people that says, I'm getting ready to emerge and I'm getting ready to come through this roof. Let's keep going because we're almost out of here. Bible says that he emerges from the roof. And after he emerges from the roof, the Bible says he's now being let down, because you got to have people that can carry you. You got to have people that can carry you. See, this is the thing. They knew his business, but look where they carried his business to. Y'all don't miss that. Come on. They knew his business, but look where they carried his business to. They carried his business to Jesus. Come on. You better have some friends that'll carry your business to Jesus and not screenshot your stuff and send it to somebody else. Bible says that they carried him to Jesus and they lowered him down to Jesus. And when they lowered him down to Jesus, Jesus looks at him. He didn't even address his palsy. He didn't even address him being paralyzed. The Bible says that Jesus says, I'm going to forgive you of your sins. I'm going to forgive you of your sins. And now, get up and walk. This is the good part. The Bible says that the same people that would not let him in the door are now the same people that have to watch him walk out of this room. The same individuals that stood in front of the door and would not let you in are the same individuals. They gotta watch you succeed, watch you do what you have never done before. I don't know who I'm talking to on this morning, but you are getting ready to go through the roof. Let me say it one more time. You are getting ready to go through the roof. You are about to do what your family has never done. You are about to do what your father has never done. You are about to do what your mother has never done. You're about to do something that your family has never produced before, because the door was too small for your God. And God said, let me put you on the roof. They ain't gonna see you coming. They ain't even gonna expect you this time. They have no idea what's getting ready to come. They're looking for you to come through the door. But guess what? You're getting ready to come through the roof. Come on, let me transition with this. When the devil stands in front of the door and tells you, you're not gonna make it, you can't come in, don't even sweat it. Find you a ladder and find you four good friends and say, you know what? We going on the roof. And let me tell you, God is waiting on you to come to the roof. This morning, we are standing on the roof because we trust God. And we know that we are getting ready to emerge. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but you are getting ready to emerge. You are getting ready to come from the bottom to the top. You're getting ready to be the head and not the tail. You're getting ready to be the lender and not the bar. Come on, can you do me a favor and say this with me? It's my season to emerge. Come on, lift your hands. Come on, lift your hands. Come on, say it with me. Say, it's my season to emerge. I know that you've been quiet. I know all the things that have been going on, but it is my season to emerge. Come on, say it with me. It is my season to emerge. It's your turn. It's your time. Everybody else has got it before you, but now your next is here. Your next is right here in this place. Your next is right now. You're not waiting another week. You're not waiting another year, but your next is right now. Now, as we transition this morning, I want you to do me a favor. If you're on this live with us on this morning, as we're worshiping on the roof, if you're on this live with us on this morning, will you do me a favor? If you're going through, if you're discouraged and you want to quit and you just need some encouragement, you just need some people to push you, you just need some people to pray with you, will you just put what your need is on the screen? And we got elders and ministers, they're standing right there ready to pray with you and ready to intercede with you to help you understand and know that you are getting ready to go through the roof. Now, we can't get off this live without encouraging the individual that says, I don't know who Jesus is. I want to get to know who Jesus is, and I want to give my life to Christ. If you're unsaved, or if you backslidden, and you said, look, God, I want to come back to you, why don't you say, Lord, I want to come back. Write that on the screen. Lord, I want to come back. And there's going to be somebody there praying with you and interceding with you. Can I pray with you on this morning? God, we thank you on this morning for your power and for your anointing. God, we thank you for your grace. And God, I speak to every sister, every brother, every man, every woman that is watching this live on this morning. And God, I speak that you will remind them that they are getting ready to go through the roof. I don't care what their past has said. I don't care what generational curses has been on them. They are getting ready to go through the roof. They are getting ready to do something that they have never been before. And we plead the blood of Jesus over their life. I plead the blood of Jesus over your career. And I speak that you will flourish in this famine, because God has you, and you will make it, and you will do it, and you will succeed, and you will survive. I speak that you will emerge in this season, that you will push forth in this season. And we declare these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, that's right. Come on, lift him up. Come on, that's it. That's it. Come on, that's it. Come on, that's it. When the devil blocks the door, guess what? Go through the roof. Listen, this is Living Faith, the church that makes you fall in love with church all over again. And we are worshiping on the roof. I love you, and I'll see you on Wednesday night at 7 p.m.